pause compressions. I'm here at the Simulation Centre of the Royal Children's Hospital, and we are practicing resuscitation of a 2-month-old baby. Now, when you hear an emergency call here in the hospital, us doctors, nurses, we drop everything and run. And the key is remaining cool and calm under pressure. Now, Aristotle was all about learning by doing, and that's why we have the simulation program, where we get to practice these low-frequency but high-intensity resuscitation and emergencies. Now, I'm joined by Dr. Meredith Allen, who is the head of medical education and the simulation program. Meredith, what can you tell us about the program here at the hospital?
Great. Well, we're incredibly excited to have the opportunity to take this money and to use it to really take our team of experts out there in the wards and help them to become an expert team. So we're going to use simulation down here, both to practice together as teams and to upgrade all our skills, as you said. But we're also going to take the simulation out to the ward, and we're going to test our systems, and we're going to improve our teamwork out in the wards, and we're really going to use it to make sure we're delivering the best and the safest patient care we can out there.
And a lot of people don't know that programs like this are almost entirely funded philanthropically. It's generosity that gets programs like these off the ground.
Absolutely. I mean, simulation is a supplement to us delivering the best care we can. It's not where we're using our primary health dollar. We couldn't do this without people's generosity. But what it does mean is we can embed this training every day on our wards to make sure our teams are as good as they possibly can be.
Fantastic, thank you very much. Now let's take a look behind the scenes through a one-way mirror where we can find the control centre, and we'll see Mitch, who controls the mannequin, the breathing, the heart rate, even the ability to vomit, have a pulse. It's very, very scary. I can tell you, when you're involved in a simulation, that mannequin starts to feel real, and it really, really makes you sweat. So Mitch, what can you tell us about the control centre and about these mannequins?
So these mannequins are a really sophisticated piece of equipment. We can make them breathe, cry, sweat, talk, seize, and we can hear heart and lung sounds. So they're extremely complicated piece of machinery that help train medical professionals.
And these things must cost an absolute fortune, I'm guessing.
So they cost between $40,000 to $130,000.
Incredible. Very, very real, realistic machines. So there's no question that practicing these high-risk situations in the simulation centre gives us doctors and nurses the strength to remain calm under pressure and ensure the best possible outcomes for patients and visitors to the Royal Children's Hospital.